snow-capped Mount Rainier, the majestic icon of Pierce County, Washington. Its lush alpine forest, a haven for wildlife and hikers alike, and flowing rivers that bring life to the valley below. At over 14,000 feet, it towers over the Puget Sound, putting on a show for more than 4 million people who live in its view every day. Not to mention the 2.5 million visitors to Mount Rainier National Park each year. Stories passed down by indigenous peoples tell us that the mountain and snow peak they know by names like Tahoma or Tacoma has an explosive history. It last erupted about 1,000 years ago. It is still an active volcano, but considered to be in between eruptions and will erupt again. Much like Mount St. Helens in 1980, Mount Rainier is the type of volcano that can explode, sending a plume of ash high into the air. During an eruption, hot rock and ash can melt ice and snow to create volcanic mud flows called lahars. Lahars are also possible during non-eruptive times.
Look at all this.
They are the consistency of wet cement and can destroy homes, roads, and bridges. Research from USGS, the United States Geological Survey, shows that a lahar could reach the outskirts of Orting in about 50 minutes and Sumner, Puyallup, and Fife within 3 hours, covering most of the valley floor. For people who live and work in Pierce County, it's important to know that the mountain has a weak side that faces the Puyallup River Valley. Some of the steep and craggy cliffs are all that remain after parts of the volcano collapsed, triggering giant landslides that flowed toward the Puget Sound. They spread across the valley floor, leaving behind thick layers of mud and boulders. In fact, every day, Orting residents drive by artifacts that were left behind by the electron mud flow 500 years ago. Large rocks and old-growth trees have been excavated from neighborhoods, uncovering layers of past lahar activity. The good news is that USGS operates a monitoring network on Mount Rainier that can detect a lahar traveling downstream. Pierce County operates more than 40 lahar sirens to alert people in populated valleys. Federal, state, and local officials are connected to this information, and they actively develop and test evacuation plans.
Stay inside the cones.
Have you noticed that school districts throughout the valley hold lahar evacuation drills?
Good job, big guy.
Students practice walking up the hillside because it's the safest, fastest way to get to higher ground. Driving may not be a safe and reliable option during an evacuation due to gridlocked roads. There are many ways that public agencies can notify you in the event of a volcanic emergency. Sign up online with PC Alert to ensure you are notified directly. PC Alert can send warnings to cell phones, landlines, and emails. You'll be directed to evacuate immediately to high ground, at least 100 feet off the valley floor. Is your family spread out during the day for school and work? How will you reunite? Make a plan now when there's not an emergency. Build a grab-and-go kit that fits into a backpack that you can carry easily during evacuation. Identify the evacuation routes closest to you and help each other. The next time you see beautiful Mount Rainier, let the mountain be a reminder to make a plan, build a kit, and help each other. We are all in this together.